Halloween Hijinks.
Yeah.
Test your might.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, WrestleZone would like to welcome you to tonight's live event. Before we begin, please be advised that all WrestleZone stars are professionally trained, so please do not copy or imitate anything you see here tonight. Please also be aware that WrestleZone is proud to provide entertainment suitable for all ages, and we ask that you refrain from using any inappropriate language this evening.
Welcome to the WrestleZone podcast. I am your host, as always, Billy. I am looking forward to this weekend's Halloween Hijinks show, even though I cannot be in attendance again. I will get back to the show eventually, guys. It's going to be Christmas chaos. That's the plan. I will be at Christmas chaos with my son's foam finger in hand over there. It's in the background. But I'm excited to see what happens, the outcomes, and everything involved with Halloween Hijinks, which we're going to take you through the card for on this episode of the WrestleZone podcast. In the meantime, we've got to talk about just everything going on. There's just so much going on coming into Halloween Hijinks. We've got things like the Tri-Counties Championship tournament ending. We'll have a new Tri-Counties champion. We've got that big, big collision between Caleb Valhalla and Monstrum. We'll get into that as well. Along with possibly, maybe, perhaps, the final showdown between the Sterling Oil Killers, the Foundation of the Future, and Scottie Swift, Omar Muhammad, and Damien. Could this be put to bed, or are we going to look ahead to chaos? Is that blue bar cage coming out to play once more? Loads more happening. And of course, former world Tag Team Champion, WWE Superstar Eugene, will be coming to the Rich Energy Arena on Saturday, October 19th. Tickets are still available. They will be pay at the door because of the size of the venue. So get your tickets now at ringsideworld.co.uk and make sure you have your ticket ready. Get your pre-show tickets at 5:30 VIP if you want to get in early, 6:30 for general, doors open, at bell time 6:15 for VIP. We'll talk about that match as well, 7 p.m. for general. Tickets are available. I'm just going to get the prices in front of me as well, because that would have been a really good idea if I'd actually done that in the first place. But you can get your tickets at ringsideworld.co.uk, or like I say, there will be walk-ups on the day because just it's such a bigger arena for WrestleZone. So if you haven't got your ticket yet, you're looking at, I'm just going on to ringsideworld.co.uk myself at this point, so you can I can give you the skinny. It's £17 for VIP plus £1.95 booking fee, or £14 for general, so you miss that opening match. Plus £1.40 booking fee on there. There will be a full write-up on WrestleZone's Facebook page if you want to find out what the meet and greet packages are like for Eugene. And you know what? I've got the internet available. I'll just tell you what they are. I'm going to find them. Look at me multitasking here on the podcast. So let's get it. So Eugene meet and greet prices for this event: £15 per signed item, which is owned item or supplied pick. £15 per picture, own phone or camera, £25 for the combo, so you get a picture and a signed item. Meet and greet takes place before and after the show, 5:30 p.m. The doors for VIP, like I said, 6 p.m. for door general, and 7 p.m. the show starts as well for the main show of the evening. So you get there. There's also public transport. You can go onto WrestleZone Scotland, facebook.com/WrestleZoneScotland. And you can find out the transport links as well for the event from the city centre in Aberdeen. So, well, a lot to get through, I think. We've got seven matches. We've got six on the pre-show. Plenty to wax lyrical about. I'm sure I'm going to find a lot of time to speak about a lot of things. We'll try my best anyway. So let's just fire into it. Rich Energy Arena Halloween Hijinks this Saturday, October 19th. Let's get into it.
Where the hell have you two been? It's at 7 o'clock.
We're here. That's what matters, huh? We're here. 7:01. We're here.
It's never
mind. We're here.
It's never mind arguing. Come on, get in here.
What is the big important thing that you have to tell us?
It's huge.
Because everything you say, everything you seem to say, is a load of waffle.
There's nothing. Sit there.
And what chairs that you have put out for us, oh generous Chris Archer.
I'll stand up then. I'll sit down, please.
So what's it? What's the big news? Tell us.
Halloween Hijinks, right? October 19th. I've got one of you to match.
You better be making up for that Ivory show, because I'm still not happy with that.
What do you mean
you're,
not happy?
You cost me the match, I would have had
to. I did no such thing. You had your wee fit. Hey. You are having a match at Halloween Hijinks.
And what am I doing?
You. I'll deal with you later. Halloween Hijinks.
Who's my opponent?
Your opponent? Judas Grey.
Well, that's a good test.
You know what?
Judas Grey. Very talented. Good test. You know what? Thank you, the one.
You're
very rare thank you.
Very smart, yeah.
You barely deserve it.
You are about. Oh, I almost forgot. It's a Halloween ball. Good luck, kid.
Wait, how long have you known this? Because we've got like a week to go.
We have just over 1 week. And you failed to stress and give me any preparation time it's a Halloween ball.
Good luck, boys.
You come. You been serious?
Archer!
Bye!
Archer!
So kicking off with the pre-show, we've got a Halloween brawl scheduled, as you just saw in that footage there. Chris Archer has put Evan Young forward for a Halloween brawl in the pre-show against none other than Judas Grey. Judas Grey is going to have a huge weekend, a big debut down in ICW that same weekend for the Zero G Championship, and he's kicking off with that as well. And he's got a big title defense next week for Discovery Wrestling. So he's got the world day's oyster. Does Judas Grey, he can come out of this with a historic Halloween brawl win and two championships to boot by the end of next weekend, which, well, you know, that's a pretty good weekend. But this match itself, Evan Young, I've mentioned in previous previews that I feel like he just needs to just roll with it. He just needs to just accept that he has got, what, 2 months, 2.5 months to put up with Chris Archer. And he's getting a marquee match on the pre-show. Not on the main show, but it's a Halloween brawl. It's a staple in the WrestleZone Halloween Hijinks calendar event. He's getting it against someone who is just setting the world on fire right now in Judas Grey. Yeah, he hasn't picked up a win in WrestleZone itself, but he's still got this massive career trajectory that he's showing and appearing in loads of different places around the country, down in England, down in Wales even. He's got tremendous upside, and getting in the ring with him is only going to do good for Evan Young. You know, he's getting all these opportunities from Chris Archer. Ollie Green, he had the tag team title shot, sure, but it seems like Archer is maybe treating Evan Young a bit meaner, a bit more arm's length, a bit hard, pushing him a bit harder to unlock and untap this potential that Evan Young has in WrestleZone. You know, I said it before, like, Evan Young is got, you know, by hook or by crook, how it happened, using that chain at Aberdeen Anarchy in the pre-show. But he's got a wealth of knowledge of the Northeast right at his fingertips. He's got Chris Archer there, former tag team champion, former tri-counties champion. He has won more titles than Evan Young. There's won more matches in WrestleZone than Evan Young's probably had hot dinners. He has got a wealth of knowledge that Evan Young could use. And he's just so stubborn about it, you know. He's been put into a Halloween brawl. Yeah, a bit short notice, perhaps. What, a week's notice? You know, that's plenty of time, I guess, as someone who's never wrestled before a day in his life. But he's getting these opportunities. Chris Archer's putting his name forward for these opportunities. I think there's something, a sparkle there Chris Archer has for Evan Young, even though Evan is just refusing to see it. Refusing to acknowledge it, refusing to give in to these temptations and opportunities that he's getting from Chris Archer. Like I said, I feel sorry for Ollie Green and all this. He's not on the card, as far as I'm aware, as far as it's been written down here. I'm sure he'll be on hand with Evan Young. But interestingly, on the flip side, Evan Young has a numbers advantage. He's got Ollie Green there. He's got Chris Archer potentially there as well. And Judas walks into this alone. We haven't seen him. We've seen him interact with with the Wallys, but that seems to have fizzled out after Abdi Anarchy. We've seen him interact in videos and promos with Ronan King. That hasn't really come to anything as yet either. But if this is leading to some sort of conglomeration between Vanity and Flippy and Drippy to maybe a six-man tag down the line. I don't know if this is like popping into my brain here. If Archer decides to try to use the numbers here, if I get down the line Chris Archer, Evan Young, and Oliver Green against Judas Grey, Ronan King, and Conor Malloy, I'll be happy with that personally as a fan. It's chaos. That'd be nice. But yeah, Judas Grey, like I say, he's just a phenomenal talent. One of my favorite wrestlers going right now in the country, just in general. I enjoy what he does. And possibly his recklessness in the ring is what's built for a Halloween brawl. We've seen what he can do with the candlestick. We can see he can be hardcore. And yeah, that's probably not a good advantage for Evan Young, but if he's got the numbers, he might not like it. But what's up with the numbers game in WrestleZone? I'm turning to Seinfeld here. What's the deal? What's the deal with the numbers game going against Judas here? He came in Christmas Chaos last year, and Tommy Raiden got in his business, and then he did return the favor at Regal Rumble, I suppose. But yeah, there's that. Anyway, yeah, so that's the pre-show match. Got Evan Young taking on Judas Grey in a Halloween brawl. This is going to be chaotic and just absolute like barbaric nature. So for those who are unaware of a Halloween brawl, all Halloween items are legal. We've seen some very sketchy Halloween items in the past in previous events. My personal favourite being Lost Boy Aspen using a bacon tray and wrote Boo on it to make it a Halloween item. Dennis Law had a very, very vague expression of what was Halloween items. Although that was probably like the most Halloween items, you know, Halloween cookies. That seems to be a thing that could be classed as a Halloween item. But we've seen things like talk about that match itself. I've got clips of it somewhere in a back catalogue of episodes on the SWN network. That's just Scottish Wrestling Network. On the SWN YouTube channel of Zach Dynamite getting body slammed onto the hard base of a bin. So this match can possibly shorten careers by a little bit, you know. And for two young guys like Evan Young and Judas Grey, they're going to go all out to leave an impression on the VIP portion. So if you're paying an extra, what was it, £3? £3 each, you know, per person, you get to see this. That's a bargain, you know. Get the pre-show match, lost by Judas Grey taking on Evan Young with Chris Archer possibly in tow. That was a bit of a ramble. Let's move on to the main show.
So once again, another show done and dusted. And another show where the foundation of the future prove that they can't get the job done on their own. I hear you guys constantly ask, Damien, Omar, Scotty, when are you going to give up? When are you going to stop? Fact of the matter is, until you guys prove that you're better than us, we won't stop.
Let's just tell the truth, because you guys won't. Inverurie, Roy Roy had to cheat to beat this man. Omar Mohammed actually scored a victory over Brad Evans, but you won't talk about that, will you, Bruiser? And Zach Dynamite had to intentionally shove me at the referee to cause a DQ because he was in the ropes and he was flapping. Now, Anarchy, Nations, Inverurie, we got left laying in all those shows, but the whole story is not being told there. Now, we know what we need to do. We need to copy what you guys are doing. We need to act like a team. We need to act like a unit. So one more Halloween Hijinks. They were saying it. The crowd in Rooney were asking for it. October 19th, Rich Energy Arena. One more time, myself, Damien, Muhammad against Foundation of the Future with Richard Russell lurking in the background. One more.
Scotty Swift, Omar Muhammad, Damien, how many outs do we have to give you? Anarchy, we let you walk away and you came back. Battle of Nations, we let you walk away and you came back. Inverurie, we left you laying again. You could have walked away and been done with all of it, but yet you want more. How stupid do you need to be? Huh? So you're asking for one more match to end this all. One more at Halloween Hijinks.
They're asking for one more match. I'm asking for one more match because Omar, we all know that you cheated to get the win.
That's right, that's right.
We all know that you are nothing but a coward.
All right.
I've seen you run away from me.
He cheated you.
He knows. They all know.
But we're not going to let that happen again, Bruiser.
They all know. We know.
I defeated a former champion in Damien. You defeated Scotty Swift, and we left them all laying. So at the end of the night,
that is true. You went right through
we
it.
Are the focal point once again. Yeah. Now Halloween is coming up, and Russell, you tell them what we're going to do.
On behalf of the Foundation of the Future, Richard R. Russell has a proclamation for WrestleZone's Halloween Hijinks. The Rich Energy Arena in Aberdeen, Saturday, October the 19th. Damien, Swift, Muhammad, you guys aren't going to go away. You aren't going to take it lying down, even though that's how we left you in the ring in Inverurie. So I'll tell you what, on behalf of Dynamite, on behalf of Riley, on behalf of Evans, we're going to give you one more chance. Contract is coming your way, boys, for Halloween Hijinks. All you've got to do is put three little signatures on that dotted line. One more six-man tag team war. And then it ends. Because the ending, what is going to happen is going to be exactly the same as we've done so far. Leave you laying. And the foundation, as always, stands strong.
Let's kick off with that big six-man tag. So we've got Scotty Swift, Omar Muhammad, and Damien taking on the Foundation of the Future, which will no doubt have Richard R. Russell in tow. Swift, Muhammad, and Damien just have had no luck against the Foundation of the Future. At every turn, the Foundation of the Future have found a way to defeat them, by hook or by crook. Most recently, thanks to Richard R. Russell, it is that crook category. But the Foundation of the Future are still a formidable force in WrestleZone, and I don't think another six-man tag is going to settle matters. These guys have just been at war. They've fought, they've brawled, they've just tore each other to pieces for the last few months. Was about this time last year it all kicked off, really. Christmas Chaos last year is kind of when this all properly kicked off with the attack on Mr. WrestleZone. And that's how Omar Muhammad was brought in. Brought on board, and then we've had a lot happening since December 2023. I don't think this is going to be the end. What you're going to get is quote-unquote not a Halloween brawl, but it's going to end up being that way. There's going to be a lot of referee discretion being used, whether it's Mikey Innes, whether it's going to be Dennis Lawers, or maybe one of the newer refs on the scene that will be in charge. We're going to see a lot of, I don't think this is the end. I think we're going to look at Christmas Chaos for the end. We've still got Stonehaven in between. So there's still plenty of time and plenty of things that can happen between now and December. What more can I say about this match? Because I've said it before for Battle of the Nations. I've said it before for Aberdeen Anarchy when William Sterling was involved and Omar was elsewhere. I've talked about this match for so long, this combination, that I don't know. Like I said, I don't think this is going to be the end. I've got a gut feeling about that. That Scotty Swift, Omar Muhammad, and Damien, possibly they'll get the win here at Halloween Hijinks. But what does that mean? The Foundation of the Future are going to want to settle it once more. They're not going to be happy with ending it on a loss. If Swift, Muhammad, and Damien lose again, then they'll probably still ask for another match, but they don't have the right to that because they've lost so many times. It's a complicated situation that Halloween Hijinks is going to escalate it further. And possibly we won't get an answer. We won't get the end. We might get, finally, a win for Swift, Muhammad, and Damien. But will it be a satisfying win for everyone involved in this match. Will Richard R. Russell be involved? Will we see William Starling make a triumphant return? And will we see some surprises? Will we see a trick or a treat? We'll go with that. That's a nice little Halloween hijinks motif to go by. But no, I don't know what more I can say about this. We've had this match before. We've tackled this one. They didn't really come to any conclusion in Inverurie with each gaining a win and on that event. I think that was the case. Unfortunately, I've missed quite a few wrestling shows this year, which I am absolutely shocked and appalled by. You know what? I'm going to go find out, because that's what we do on the podcast. We just I start saying things and think, you know what? I'm going to go check this and just kill time while I'm doing it. So we've got Ryan Riley defeated. We've got Omar defeated Bruiser Brad. Ryan Riley defeated Damien. And then Zach Dynamite defeated Scotty Swift by disqualification. So technically on that night, the Foundation and the Future won 2-1. But that big DQ is looming large, with the Foundation beating down Swift, Muhammad, and Damien afterwards. So I think Swift, Muhammad, and Damien need to win. They need to win. They need to actually get a notch on this belt, because I can't, bar Muhammad defeating Bruiser Brad Evans, which is incredible, by the way, the Foundation have had the answer to every question that Damien and co, because he's the common denominator here, Damien has had for this group. It's, yeah, it'll be an interesting night at the Rich Energy Arena, and which is where this big six-man thing it started, really. The actual match itself, we've got to see Abney Anarchy this year, Scotty Swift getting clashed through a table, so Damien ending the night getting cable tied to a barrier. Will they get a bit of redemption tonight? On that night at the Rich Energy Arena on October 19th. We'll find out this weekend.
12 years. It took me 12 years to become WrestleZone Undisputed Champion. And 525 days later, it's gone. And I don't blame Caleb Valhalla. He was the better man on that day. But ever since then, I've been thinking, maybe I can't do this anymore. So I sat out Battle of the Nations. I tried my hand at commentary and just didn't feel right. All I need is one win to sort my head out. And after watching your performance against Caleb Valhalla, Rhys Dawkins, you are the man that I have chosen for that match. And this isn't just an opportunity for you to prove yourself, but this is a test for me to see if I've still got this. And like I said, all I need is one more match.
I was this close to defeating the undisputed champion. And I maybe didn't get the win on that night, but I've proven exactly what I'm capable of. And it seems others are beginning to notice as well. At Halloween Hijinks on October 19th at the Rich Energy Arena, I face the lost boy, Aspen. Now, Aspen, you've been talking about how you need this victory, that you need this one win. The former WrestleZone Undisputed Champion, the first Grand Slam champion in WrestleZone history, and you need this win? No. I need this win. I need this victory. And mark my words, Rhys Dawkins is going to do everything to get that victory. I will break your spirit. I will tear at the very vestiges of your self-esteem. I will burn whatever faith that you have left in yourself to ash. Until my hand is raised and my name is etched into WrestleZone history alongside yours.
After that ramble, hopefully this will be a little bit more concise. We've got Lost Boy Aspen making his in-ring return since his loss at Aberdeen Anarchy against Caleb Valhalla. He's returned to WrestleZone to a WrestleZone ring since then. Was that May? Against Rhys Dawkins. Rhys Dawkins coming off a loss against Caleb Valhalla and Inverurie. Rhys Dawkins, though, from what I've heard, from what I've seen and heard, put in a tremendous showing against Caleb Valhalla with the title on the line. The Undisputed Wrestling Championship was on the line on that night. So it's Rhys is maybe not getting the wins, but he's certainly putting in the work and the performances to equivalent getting bigger opportunities and working towards those, getting catching the eye of management, catching the eye of Mr. Patterson, whoever it needs to be, in order to move and get bigger iron, sharpening iron opponents. And Lost by Aspen is that kind of guy. Lost by Aspen, last time we saw him in WrestleZone, it didn't really end well for him. So he lost the title at Aberdeen Anarchy to Caleb Valhalla, and then he returned at Battle of the Nations to be on commentary and end up getting chokeslammed by Monstrum at the end of the night and lost his hat. So it's not been a great WrestleZone year in WrestleZone for Aspen since Aberdeen Anarchy onwards. So he's looking to try and get back in the groove. The only Triple Crown and Grand Slam champion in WrestleZone history, looking to get back on the saddle and maybe work his way back into the title picture. Unaware if there's any rematch clauses for the WrestleZone Undisputed Championship. Perhaps there is. Maybe we'll get Aspen and Caleb one more time before the end of the year. But I think Caleb's got a little bit of a distraction at the moment in the form of Monstrum. But Rhys Dawkins, he's one of the guys I've just enjoyed watching in WrestleZone. He's just one of those really, really talented individuals who shows so much character and embodies. He's been dealing with Brian Tucker and part of the Warriors Against Low Life entities. He's been a bit of a silly goose at times, but I think he's in ring and the quality of his work is certainly worth noting and worth watching as well. So Dawkins and Aspen both need a win. They both said they need a win. You saw in the footage, they both want and need a win, and one of them will probably get it, unless it's like a count out, double count out, and then we're at a bit of a stalemate. But as match itself, Dawkins and Aspen have collided a couple times, I think they have, certainly in a triple threat match, I remember in Inverurie last year, where Aspen was determined to elbow drop Rhys Dawkins' book. Whether that happens again remains to be seen. Wouldn't that be an ultimate trick on Rhys Dawkins to lure him back into a match with Lost by Aspen and only to have his Book of Shakespeare get elbow drop one more time? But Dawkins, you know me, I'm a big Aspen guy. I am an absolute humongous Aspen guy. I am an obese Aspen guy. I've got a funny feeling Dawkins might do something surprising. I think this is a dark horse match of the night for my reckoning, for my uneducated opinion. We're going to see Lost by Aspen, Rhys Dawkins. Keep an eye on that one if you're going to this event on Saturday. If you haven't got a ticket and you're tempted to go, I mean, there's great stuff we're going to talk about. That Aspen, Rhys Dawkins match, a bit of an extra eye, if possible. I don't know how that's possible. But go check that one out. Anyway, let's move on.
Whoa, Brian, be careful,
what,
careful.
What, Jane? There's something on the floor here, I noticed.
I know this joke. That is a small, off-duty Czechoslovakian traffic warden. I knew this one, I knew it.
No, this is Tommy Raiden. Because Tommy Raiden has been getting by on banana skins in this tournament. He's been winning by fluke and by chance. So Brian, I'm going to teach you how to avoid falling victim to the same traps. Let's go.
No. Let's split!
Tra-la-la, tra-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la-la-la-la, tra-la-la, tra-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la-la-la-la. One banana, two banana, three banana, four bananas make a bunch and so do many more. Show. Making up a mess of fun.
stockings. Thank you so much. I now feel fully prepared for Halloween hijinks. Tommy Raiden, you've been fluking your way just like this little banana skin, but I've shown you that I can avoid it. So Saturday night, it's time to say hello to your new Tri-Counties champion. It's happening. Thank you, Reese. It's happening. Yes. Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go. Whoa. Ow. Sorry.
Let's get into championship mode then. Brian Tucker, Tommy Raiden, Tri-Counties Championship Tournament will conclude at Halloween Hijinks at the Rich Energy Arena on October 19th. A final I did not see coming. That was not a final. You know, you gave me, I think I've done plenty of previews on the way up when this tournament was announced. We did the road trip as well for Battle of the Nations. I've done the previews as well. I did not expect this one. This was not the final I anticipated. So that just goes to show how terrible I am at predicting things in WrestleZone. You know, we'll go with that. So Tommy Raiden's road to victory, road to the final here. He defeated Judas Gray at Battle of the Nations. He then defeated Captain Alan Sterling in the semi-final in Inverurie. And that's then led to the final of this tournament to come the first ever, well, come to pick up his first ever title in WrestleZone. First ever title in general as well. First bit of gold in the camp of Tommy Raiden. Of course, he is mentored by former Tri-Counties champion Mickey Vago. So Vago's got, you know, probably got a little bit of some tips and tricks, especially against his opponent. Brian Tucker defeated Evan Young in the quarterfinal at Battle of the Nations, then defeated Oliver Green in Inverurie to lead himself to the final in this match. Brian Tucker would only be the second man to hit the modern day Triple Crown if he wins this match. He's won the Undisputed Wrestling Championship. He's won the Tag Team Championships with Sean Johnson as part of the Grand City Hotshots. This is the title he needs to complete that set. Has he won the Rumble? Don't think he's won the Rumble. I'm going to go double check that now because I've checked everything else while I'm on here. So I'll be able to go check this as well. But I don't think he has. Let's see. Brian Tucker. I am shocked and appalled. 2011. Regal Rumble win for Brian Tucker. So his first Undisputed Wrestling Championship was 28th of January 2012. He then won the Tag Team Championships later that year, 30th of June 2012, with Sean Johnson as the Grand City Hotshots with that Regal Rumble win in 2011. So, scratch everything I just said there. If Brian Tucker wins this match and becomes Tri-Counties Champion, he'll complete the Grand Slam, the second person to complete that feat after Lost Boy Aspen in 2022. So that's pretty big, pretty historic all round for whoever wins this match. Tommy Raiden become the first, winning his first ever piece of gold in WrestleZone, or Brian Tucker becoming the second ever Grand Slam winner in WrestleZone history. That's two pretty big things, pretty big deals, you know? I say this is not a final I expected, but this is the final we have. With the names that are in there, I was thinking Alex Webb might go a little bit further. I thought Judas Gray might go a little bit further. I even thought maybe Rhys Dawkins would be in this position in the final. But the veteran, Brian Tucker, is the one who's outlasted everyone. And people, like, he's been a bit of a wally, you know, this last little while, for the last 2 years or so. He's been a bit of a wally. But he's much like Captain Allen. Like, you can't discount his tenacity and his that experience in WrestleZone. He's been able to pick up these wins and been able to get into positions where he could become a champion. And that could happen on Saturday, October 19th, the Rich Energy Arena. Brian Tucker could become WrestleZone Tri-Counties Champion. And I think that would be, maybe that will snap him out of his walliness. You know, way back when this title was established, when the first ever Tri-Counties Champion was crowned, that was way back in, I'm trying to get the year because I have got brain like mints at the moment, 2017 when this title was established. Abney Anarchy Beach Ballroom. The final was lost by Aspen, who won the match. It was along with Bingo Balance, Brian Tucker and Zach Dynamite. It was Zach Dynamite. So Brian Tucker has been contention of his title, or been trying to get hold of this title, since the very inception of the title itself in WrestleZone. So he's going to go in for that. He's going to try and become the Triple Crown Grand Slam, whatever you want to call it, in WrestleZone, entirely possible. From his current, he's got a bit of a win streak going on, you know? The win in at Nations, the win at Inveruri, and here we are in the final here at Halloween Hijinks. Tommy Raiden has been learning and growing fast in WrestleZone. He had a great match with Judas Gray. And then he fought and defeated Captain Allen. Captain Allen, again, guy who may present himself as a bit of a buffoon, but multi-time tag team champion. Tri-Counties champion in the past as well. Main events in WrestleZone. He has done quite a lot in WrestleZone, has Captain Allen. So Tommy Raiden was able to get past that roadblock into the final. I can't call it. You know, I would love to go, right, this is who's going to win. I think this is going to be the de facto winner. But you know, when it comes to WrestleZone, I don't know. I just can't predict it. I'm terrible. I'm absolutely awful. I wish I could go magic ball, this is who's going to win. And then I can kind of sit back and relax. But I don't relax when I'm waiting for results, when I want to see the results on Facebook if I can't attend the event. I have to just wait with bated breath. So I'll be sitting there. I'll be at home, probably. Yeah, we'll be at probably that point. I'm at a show during the day elsewhere. Not a wrestling show, if anyone thinks I'm cheating on WrestleZone. But I'll be at an event elsewhere that day, so I'll be at home with bated breath waiting for the results to find out who's going to be the new WrestleZone Tri-Counties champion. Will it be the era of Tommy Raiden, or will Brian Tucker create history and become that to etch his name to the second ever Grand Slam Triple Crown winner in WrestleZone history? It's an exciting time, it's an exciting match. Will the only answer question mark will be, will Tommy be doing it on his own, or will Mickey Vega be there? He's not actually, is Vega scheduled for a match? I don't think he is. Mickey Vega's not scheduled for a match, so QB Vega will be there with Tommy Raiden, or will Brian Tucker have Rhys Stockings in hand as well to assist? So there's going to be a lot of things at play. Of course, it's going to be Tommy and Brian. The Wallys and Speed Metal have been at each other's throats for the last year or so. So we're going to maybe cap this off once and for all. When the Tri-Counties champion is crowned to the Rich Energy Arena. It's going to be so if you bought your ticket, you're guaranteed to get a new champion. You know, if you go into this event going, it's predictable. Predictable. We're going to see things that nobody's going to lose a title here. There's no weird title changes. You will. This is a guarantee you're going to see a new WrestleZone Tri-Counties champion on Saturday at the Rich Energy Arena in Aberdeen. Get your ticket, ringsideworld.co.uk. Tickets will be available at the door, but limited, so get your ticket in advance so you don't miss out.
Murphy, how dare you? How dare you use that tape, tape my legs around that post and make me watch as you pinned that idiot Chris Archer? No, that's not fair. That's not fair, that's cheating, mate. You don't do that. I mean, the whole match was a cheat. He was streaming on ahead. He didn't have a tag partner. How can you be tag team champions without a tag partner? We should have been given the belts immediately the second Dino didn't show his ass up.
And at Halloween Hijinks, we've got a switcheroo match.
Don't get me started. I've got to wear their awful dregs.
Oh. If I got to get my hair all greasy like Dino's or look like a bloody ogre like Murphy, we all know the only thing that's going to be switcherooing at Halloween is us getting those tag team titles back.
We continue the title action with the WrestleZone Tag Team Championships on the line in a Halloween switcheroo match, which is the Outfit will be defending against Flippy and Drippy. So the Outfit, by the graphic, we know that doesn't mean anything at the moment, thanks to Battle of the Nations, but the graphic suggests it's going to be Ted O'Keefe and Murphy taking on the team of Ronan King and Connor Malloy. So for those that are unaware what a Halloween switcheroo match is, essentially the Outfit are going to come out dressed as Flippy and Drippy, hilarious, and Flippy and Drippy will be coming out dressed as the Outfit. Fantastic. You know, this is all things that I can't wait to see the photos of. So Kirsten and Brian are going to be on photo duties. I will be looking and waiting for bated breath to see what they look like, because it just sounds incredible. I've seen a couple of Halloween switcheroo matches in the past. The most notable one in my head is the Foundation of the Future taking on Sean Johnson and Mr. P, where we got to see Ryan Riley in a bald cap. And that was fun. That was a fun night for me, you know, as a bald man. All people unite. But it's going to be, it's one of those things, right? So the outfit won the titles back, Battle of the Nations. Fantastic. The Dino returned, took the place of Ted O'Keefe before the, well, technically when the bell rang, Murphy was on his own, but Dino came in to make the tag. At Inverurie, Dino got attacked, so it was Murphy defending on his own in a triple threat tag team match. So he was able to retain the titles at that point as well. So the question is Ted O'Keefe or Dino going to be healthy, you know, to face Murphy? Or are we going to, or is there going to be some shenanigans again that only Murphy will be there defending the tag team championships? We've got that in hand. Second thing is, who's going to be who? You know? Because I don't know. You tell me. Murphy with a pink feather boa from Conor Malloy. That's quite cool. That's going to be fun. I just like the visual in my head of that. We're going to see Ted O'Keefe with the wee glasses and the camo gear, the pink and black camo. Oh man, this is going to be a hell of a lot of fun. None of these guys are going to enjoy this, you know. Flippy and Drippy are going to be wanting to get the titles back, of course. Murphy and Ted will be wanting to retain. I don't think either are going to enjoy the aesthetic that they are presented with. But, you know, I think Murphy is going to have a... I think we're going to see a little bit of a surprise from Murphy. Murphy, we've never really seen how fun, you know. He's always been quite stoic. He's always been quite angry. Even when the crowd are now behind him, he's still quite angry. So a hangry fella. I think give him a bit of pink flair. Give him a bit of a pink feather boa. Get him some big sexy glasses. I think we're going to have a good time with Murphy at Halloween Hijinks. As we're going to get to see a new side of the Mauler himself, Mauler Murphy. We're going to see a good time with him. I think Ted's going to be grumpy. That's going to... I think he'll have fun. The eyes will say, "I'm furious," you know, that kind of dynamic. But that may just give him the urge and the spur and the anger and rage he needs to make this defense a successful one for the outfit. So that could be the case as well. I think it's going to be a hell of a lot of fun. Halloween switcheroo match with the outfit defending against Flippy and Drippy. We talked about like Aspen and Reese possibly being a match of the night. I think this is going to be the one that people are going to walk out of remembering the most, perhaps, when the switcheroo happens for this particular bout. But this is going to be a hell of a fun night in the Change Arena for this match. It's going to be this is the treat, the treat portion for the crowd, possibly a trick for the four guys involved. But people are going to enjoy it. I can't wait to see clips for this match.
It has been a tremendous year for Alan Sterling. 2024. The year of the sea, and every Nanaki I picked up my hat again. And then I moved on and beat Alex Webb, and I'm through to the next leg of the tournament for the Tri-Counties Championship, a championship I'd already owned and should just be given, but never mind, I'll beat everyone and earn it back again. Then between those momentous achievements, I picked up a sea dog, as you can see, one of my sea adventures. Say hi, sea dog, say hi. I'm sorry, he can't say hi. He only likes me. Sea dog, don't worry. Don't worry, sea dog. Oh, you're a beauty. Anyway, enough about you. Shut up. I know somebody else is coming to Aberdeen. Not just my sea dog. At Halloween Hijinks, coming dressed as himself, is Eugene. Well, Mr. Eugene, I haven't heard much about you. I don't know much about you, but you probably know a lot about me. And year 2024 is probably why you're coming to Aberdeen to try and make your name off of me. Now, like many have come before you, it won't work, because Eugene, you might have achieved or crossed a lot in the States, but you're coming to Scotland. You're coming to the biggest country in the world, and where I am practically king. So Eugene, at Halloween, come as you may, you'll learn. It's all about Alan. Say hi, shut up.
So before we get into the main event, I've got to talk about the guy who meant this night moved. It was supposed to be, I think it was supposed to be at Danesden Community Centre, if I remember rightly, this particular event. But due to getting this particular person on the show, it was moved to the Rich Energy Arena, a bigger venue, for this particular event, for Halloween Hijinks. Former World Tag Team Champion William Regal, it's Eugene Dinsmore, is coming to the Granite City this Saturday. He'll be in a match with Captain Alan Sterling, former WWE superstar, against the most... how do you describe Captain Alan Sterling? I don't know at this point. He's an enigma wrapped in a mystery. You saw the video there. He doesn't know a lot about Eugene, but he's determined and knows that Eugene knows a lot about him. We'll take that as the sentence. Eugene, he was a controversial figure in WWE, wasn't he? Let's not lie here. He was a controversial figure. Fun-loving, yes, but possibly a 2005, possibly not a PG character at that time. Maybe some nostalgia has softened that a bit, but I'd be interested to see the reaction Eugene gets in the Rich Energy Arena at Halloween Hijinks. He's an awesome star. I was a fan with it back in the day. Just to be honest with you, he was a superstar. I did enjoy the Eugene character. But I know that he puts on, he'll put on a fantastic match. He'll entertain the audience. And I think putting him in with Captain Alan Sterling possibly has maximized the entertainment factor to an 11. You know, Captain Alan Sterling is I've mentioned, like I say, a buffoon. But he's one play things in WrestleZone. He is a dangerous wrestler when he needs to be. He doesn't need to be all the time. I think he might need to be when he goes up against someone of the stature of Eugene. It's going to be an interesting match. It's going to be bums on seats. People are wanting to meet former WWE star like Eugene. And it's one of those things where I usually would be like, yes, amazing, Gangrel's coming to WrestleZone. I loved Gangrel growing up. Like, you know, Gangrel was my guy. It was a cool guy to see with the vampire dude and all that kind of stuff. Just Eugene was that character I liked. So I don't want to sit here and go, it's going to be, amazing. Oh, because I can't fake that, you know. But for people that want to see Eugene, absolutely, go see him. Go see Eugene. I've heard nothing but nice things about him as a person. Meet and greets, you hear great things about him. As a teacher, as a wrestler as well, his actual in-ring quality, fantastic. But yeah, he's not a guy for me. I wrestling matches would have made me want to go to the show, but like I say, I am busy that day, so I can't go. Anyway, I think I've rambled myself into a pit. I'm going to try and climb my way out of it. Go see it. If you get a meeting great, get to meet Eugene, and that's going to be an absolute, we'll talk about the chaos of the Halloween Brawl. I think this is going to be a good fun, a good laugh. People are going to have a good time. Promise. Don't let my dour attitude sway you away. Go get your ticket at ringsideworld.co.uk for this match, for the show in general, for Halloween Hijinks at the Rich Edge Arena. It's going to be that's going to be one of the ones. Halloween Switcher is going to be hilarious. Eugene and Captain Allen, I think that's going to be a spectacle. We'll say that. Spectacle instead. Yeah. Let's look at the main event.
Monstrum. You dare come to the mighty Caleb's realm. You dare come to WrestleZone. You want my attention? You've got it. I've laid out the challenge, just like you laid out the mighty Caleb, the Battle of the Nations, just like you laid out the mighty Caleb's brother, Lost Boy Aspen. And the Drangers of the realm fell silent. But still, they cheer for the mighty Caleb. They rally behind their Jarl, their undisputed champion. The mighty Caleb knows no fear, they say. The mighty Caleb fears no man. But then Monstrum, the mighty Caleb knows fear. The mighty Caleb has seen atrocities across space and time. The mighty Caleb has battled monsters in places too terrifying to speak of. Monstrum! The mighty Caleb knows fear, but the mighty Caleb knows courage. The mighty Caleb knows heart. The mighty Caleb knows strength. And the mighty Caleb does not know when to stay down. Monstrum! You want to follow the mighty Caleb? You have to follow him till the end of time, because I will not die by your hand. You want to come to the mighty Caleb's realm? You want to unburden the mighty Caleb? You come to fail, Monstrum! Halloween Hijinks, test your might! Skull! Skull! Skull!
So way back at the Regal Rumble, after Caleb Valhalla threw out Alan Sterling to become the 2024 Regal Rumble winner, a countdown appeared, and it appeared out of nowhere. Nobody understood it. People were confused. And I wasn't. What was the next event after that? I'm very confused myself there, in between. Peterhead? Was it Peterhead? That's not right. Yes, it was. I'm going to go check. Because that's just what we do here. I'm terrible for this today. Just fact checking myself on these shows. We saw the countdown again anyway. I'm gonna check when it was. It was just Army Anarchy, wasn't it? Army Anarchy. Countdown happened again after Caleb defeated Aspen to become the Undisputed Wrestling Champion. And then after that, it may have happened to Ellen. I'm not sure. There's Ellen was in between. Peterhead was in February. That was before Regal Rumble, for those that want to try and figure out what's happening in my brain there. So this countdown happened again. Confusion. Didn't know what was happening. I had my tinfoil hat. I had my conspiracy theories going already. You know, I was like, who's it going to be? I thought it was going to be Richard R. Russell. That was my guess. That was my thought and opinion. It was going to be Richard R. Russell. He's brought someone back. He's bringing someone to take out Caleb Valhalla, you know? We got the answers of Battle of the Nations. Richard Russell was not involved. We got the answer when the countdown happened again after Caleb Valhalla defeated Mickey Vago to retain the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship. Countdown happened. Countdown went down and Monstrum was revealed. Monstrum came out and attacked Caleb Valhalla. He chokeslammed, lost by Aspen, who was at commentary, and stood tall over Valhalla and Aspen. With the intentions very clear to destroy Caleb Valhalla and take everything that Caleb had built and built up towards. These guys are very familiar with each other down in Discovery Wrestling. We've seen plenty of battles through Skull Brawl and the good times, and they just get wild and crazy and just everywhere, you know? Two big guys just brute forcing, like throwing themselves, throwing clubbing blows, throwing fists, and throwing boulders at each other. We're going to see a Halloween Hijinks. Monstrum is terrifying. You know, I had the handler for Monstrum. I had Charles Douglas on the SWN podcast. Very recently, actually. It was after Battle of Nations. And he tries to control Monstrum. But Monstrum can't be controlled. And slowly but surely, over the years, Monstrum's taking more and more control over his actions, you know? So we've seen that evolve. We've seen the mask of Monstrum evolve as well. It used to just be kind of like a balaclava with a mask at the front. It slowly like become this kind of skin, this skin crafted and stitched together as Monstrum takes over the conscience of Charles Douglas to just do whatever he wants and be a destructive force. And he's made his way to the Northeast. He's made his way to WrestleZone to take everything that Caleb Valhalla has built. You know, Caleb's been a guy that people have fallen in love with in WrestleZone. The crowd, he properly debuted as Captain Alan Starling's muscle, but body is his crew. And since then, people have just gravitated and supported Caleb all the way to when he became Tri-County champion, to when he became Undisputed Wrestler champion. And here's the spoiler in Monstrum. Monstrum is coming to absolutely wreck everything in his path. This will be Monstrum's first match in WrestleZone. He did make an appearance at Inverurie. So this will be the first time that people will get to see Monstrum properly. They'll get to be able to digest Monstrum properly. He's not going to be coming out from the crowd and battering Caleb with no I suppose there was prior warning with the video, but there's no prior warning for what you expect when you see Monstrum, because he is terrifyingly big. He's terrifying with a mask. His eyes are cold, dead, and he's coming to just wreak havoc in WrestleZone. I don't think we've seen a force like this since Crusher Crane. Crusher Crane, when he was just the creator of Carnage, that's the kind of thing you're going to get here at Halloween Hijinks. For those that are in attendance, those that should be going, listen, wish I was. But you're going to see Monstrum and Caleb. This is going to be King Kong versus Godzilla. And you can pick which side is which in that respect, in that analogy. It's going to be absolutely carnage. Going to be carnage in the Rich Edge Arena on October 19th. And we can mention all the fun stuff that we're going to see. You know, we're going to see the fun stuff of the switcheroo match. We're going to see the fun stuff of Eugene and Captain Allen. We're going to see the fun stuff Brian Tucker is probably going to get involved. This won't be fun. This will be two big guys just tearing each other apart. You know, this is going to be possibly uncomfortable to watch at times when Monstrum gets his hands on Caleb and is able to keep Caleb grounded and keep him from being able to swing his arms or anything like that. It's going to be uncomfortable to watch at times, but you're not going to be able to take your eyes off it. It's going to be a car crash, and you're just going to not be able to look away. His third defense of the title. He defeated Mickey Vago at Battle Nations, defeated Rhys Dawkins at Inverurie. So this is his third defense, and it's against an unknown entity to the WrestleZone audience in Monstrum. And that always sets the tension high. People will, could Monstrum walk out as undisputed WrestleZone champion? Could Caleb manage to lift and slam the giant? We have to find out. October 19th, Rich Edge Arena, ringserveworld.co.uk. Go get your ticket. Go get the VIP ticket so you can see Judas versus Evan Young. That's the only way you're going to find out. And I'm going to have to, like I say, I'm going to sit back and just wait and with bated breath of photos and videos. Have you? I got a little bit serious, didn't I? So let's take it to the aftermath. Yeah, that got a little bit serious towards the end there, but let's look at the overall card. You can go to swnscotland.com. We'll have the full card. You can also do the same at WrestleZone on their Facebook channels, Instagram as well. Go check out. You can find out what's coming up. You can get directions, transport, and links to everything as well, along with videos on the YouTube channel, which we have spliced in. You can go see the full videos because I do chop a little bit out towards the end. So you go check all those bits and pieces out for your eyeballs, and the occasional free match as well if you want to see some matches from previous events. I think the last one uploaded was Caleb and Connor from last year's Summerhill Station Hotel Showdown, I think, which was incredible. It was a really, really great match. Go check it out. So we've got 6 matches on the main card, 1 on the VIP pre-show. So the Halloween Brawl, Judas Grey versus Evan Young, for those that paid an extra couple quid to go into the VIP section of the day. And then elsewhere, Scotty Swift, Omar Muhammad, and Damian taking on the Foundation of the Future, which we've got Lost by Aspen taking on Rhys Dawkins, Eugene, former WWE star and World Tag Team Champion Eugene, against Captain Alan Sterling. And the Wrestling Tag Team Championships will be defended in a Halloween switcheroo match when the Outfit defend against Flippy and Drippy. Halloween on my mind here. WrestleZone Tri-Couch Championship Tournament Final will take place when Tommy Raiden takes on Brian Tucker to determine the new WrestleZone Tri-Couch Champion. And the WrestleZone Undisputed Championship will be on the line when Caleb Valhalla defends against Monstrum. Get your tickets for that show taking place this weekend. Like I said, tickets will be limited on the door, but if you get them in advance, then you can guarantee you being able to get into the show. Elsewhere, we've got more shows and that coming up. And that. So I think I've really caught myself off guard with the big senior section with Caleb and Monstrum. Elsewhere, we've got Stonehaven coming up, which is on Friday the 15th of November, uncharacteristic Friday event. You can go get your tickets at ringsideworld.co.uk and for that. We've got plenty of people on the poster, all your usual favourites. So we'll get the match card soon for that, and we'll do a preview for that event. So that's only a month away. So if you're in the Stonehaven area, Stonehaven seems to be snake bit. We're trying to get a show there, because last year it was supposed to be Stonehaven, and then because of storm, whatever it was called, Bertha, or what the storm was called, ended up getting cancelled, with Halloween Hijinks taking its place. So finally, WrestleZone will be at the Victoria Halls in Stonehaven. We'll get a ticket for that if you so wish. But in the meantime, we've got lots going on this weekend for WrestleZone. Keep an eye out on their social media. Keep an eye out on our social media and our website as well, because we'll have the results as soon as they go up. We will do the old copy and paste and get them up on our site. And it's going to be an interesting show. Like I said, I'm guided to be missing it. I will, Christmas Chaos will be the next one I will be at. So we'll do a preview for Stonehaven, and we'll do a preview for Christmas Chaos, and then a recap for Christmas Chaos, and then we'll do a road trip episode for the SWN podcast as well. So there'll be plenty of things to come on our network of shows on the Scottish Wrestling Network on YouTube. So go check out all the back catalogue of interviews and everything else in between. In the meantime, I think I've taken up a lot of your time, enough of your time perhaps you could say. I thank you very much for listening. Thank you very much for joining us for the WrestleZone podcast. Hope you have a good time. Enjoy the show. Make me totally jealous and get lots of clips and pictures so I can see what's happening. And just make me just like go, oh my God, I can't believe I couldn't go. That's the best thing to do, right? You know, just make me jealous. If there's anything to take away from this podcast, is make me jealous. But thank you very much. I've been your host as always. I don't remember if I've done it a bit already because I have a terrible memory. I've been your host, Billy. This has been WrestleZone Podcast. Go enjoy some wrestling. And I can't remember how to wrap these up. Stay hydrated. You know, have a good time.